At last week's Delivering Alpha Summit, I'd asked SEC Chairman Jay Clayton about what has happened and what has to happen to see Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies on exchanges. Here's what he had to say.
People see the price of Bitcoin trading on whatever report it is. If they think that there's the same rigor around that price discovery as there is on the NASDAQ or the New York Stock Exchange and the protections, they're sorely mistaken. So, you know, we have to get to a place, in my view, this is just speaking for myself, we have to get to a place where we can be confident that that trading is, let's see, better regulated.
Joining us right now to talk cryptocurrency is Blockstack co-founder and CEO Muneeb Ali. He recently completed the first ever SEC-qualified token sale to retail investors. Good morning to you. We should probably explain to investors and our audience what that even means. But before we get there, I want to ask you this. My take on Chairman Clayton's comments throughout have been that he is reluctant, really, to get to go too far down either the Bitcoin road or, frankly, any of the crypto road, that he, you know, he is less of not an evangelist, but I think has true and genuine concerns about it. Do you think that's the right way to read him?
Well, I think so. But at the same time, I remain cautiously optimistic about the work that the SEC is doing. This is actually reminding me of an interview you were doing with Chairman Clayton. I was in the audience, and we were talking about regulations.
About a year ago when we did this, or maybe 6 months ago.
Yeah, 6 months ago. And I was like so confident that our SEC offering is going to get qualified, but I couldn't say anything about it, right, at that time. I think we're in a similar situation where there are a lot of exchanges that are trying to get their appropriate licenses from FINRA, and SEC does a passive approval. And right now, like, we can't say in a very confident way that, yes, they will get their appropriate licenses.
Explain so the audience understands what you just did and what the SEC did approve.
Sure. So basically, think about the Wild West time of 2017, the quote-unquote ICOs. And it was basically unregulated, so much hype and speculation happening in the market. And in the U.S., the stance was pretty much like the SEC is just waiting, and they're not really issuing any.
And just to be clear for the audience what an ICO is, these are effectively coins which were developed you could found a company effectively or finance a company using these coins. It would be it would be instead really of having any kind of offering in the future.
Yes, instead of selling equity in a company, they would just sell these tokens, sometimes to the general public. Which, like, when we looked at the models, we're a company that has been building a decentralized computing network for 5 years now, and there's a real need for such crypto assets on our network. But when we looked at this market, we basically decided to work with the regulators. Imagine that the SEC has never approved a crypto asset ever before. In fact, like, the securities regulations have been around since 1933, and they rarely, if ever,
approve. So you can sell coins effectively now yourself?
Our offering is closed. Right. We raised around $23 million in the token offerings, but that process of working with the SEC took around a year, like around 9 months.
And what does this say, though, about what, you know, we talk about Bitcoin, the future of Bitcoin, the future of all of these coins, and whether they need to get on exchanges, whether they need to get different types of regulatory approval to get to this next, whatever you think the next place is, the promised land of all of this. How much does it really rest on people like Jay Clayton and the SEC, given and the work that you've now done with them?
I think a lot. So the work we have done is half of the picture, meaning that any new company that wants to issue these assets now has a framework for how to issue them, right? The second half of the picture is where are these assets going to trade in the U.S.? And that's a comment I made earlier about these regulated exchanges. And most of the big players in our industry, they're trying to get these appropriate licenses. And I think that would complete the picture where not only you can issue these assets, but you can also trade them in a fully regulated way.
How has your token traded since you had this offering? And do you care? I mean, because for the future of other ICOs, they should care, because if the tokens are trading and they're really illiquid or the pricing is erratic and the value goes lower, I would think investors are less inclined to invest because you get nothing basically in exchange. You're not getting a piece of the company.
Yes. So currently in the U.S., there are no regulated exchanges where it can trade. Mm-hmm. Internationally, the regulations are different. So depending on the jurisdiction you're in, it's treated as what's called a utility token, mm-hmm. right? Meaning that the securities regulations don't apply in those jurisdictions. So interestingly, we're a U.S. company, and it's entirely possible that the token trades internationally first, meaning the U.S. investors won't be able to participate until these regulated exchanges exist in the U.S.
So what are you telling me in terms of if I had invested in your ICO and I have X number of tokens, what are they worth?
That depends on the market price.
Okay.
Initially, that would be international, meaning that, right. Yes, you can see the ticker, but you can't really participate as a U.S. investor.
It's still very difficult. I mean, for investors, it's still, I mean, you've sort of broken the ground in terms of getting the first SEC approval for this ICO, but at the same time, there's still a lot of snags in this whole process in terms of the actual liquidity of trading of this token. There are things that need to be sort of ironed out still.
Yeah, I think the biggest step is going to be when the Coinbases of the world mm-hmm. actually get their licenses for these regulated exchanges. And I remain very, very confident that they will.
He's very bullish on Bitcoin. What about you?
I'm long-term bullish on Bitcoin. I think the clips that you played from Chairman Clayton, he's basically talking about price discovery, that in Bitcoin, there's like so much fake volume. I think there was a report by Bitwise that they reported that something like 95% of the volume on for Bitcoin is actually fake, and that's the thing that concerns the SEC a lot, right? And there has been a lot of effort to educate them about how you can actually separate out the fake volume from more trusted like sources.
You remember that my feelings about Bitcoin were engendered by Libra.
By Facebook's Libra.
Because everything that Bitcoin had, none of
right.
that's apparent in Libra. So it's just to say I'm very bullish. And then this is what happened. So we have a technical analyst on. Katie Stockton. She looks at charts. So I jokingly said, on the Bitcoin chart, do you see an objective of 55,000? Because the next halving is in May of 2020, and that if you use stock to flow and it goes to gold's stock to flow number of 60 or so, that's what it implies. But now I'm supposedly forecast. I'm like Tom Lee. I'm like the Tom Lee. And I don't make forecasts. I have no idea. But I understand the math a little bit better. I don't understand it completely, and I understand blockchain a little bit. So I see that it does have value and unforgeable value or scarcity or whatever. So to just say I'm bullish, I'm uncomfortable for you
right.
saying that. Are you bullish? What would you say you are in Bitcoin?
I don't know where I am. I'm in a very, very mixed place.
See, that's what I need to say, too, because
where are you on Ethereum or Ripple or any of these other kinds of currencies?
I think
or Libra, for that matter.
So I think Ethereum is a interesting experiment, and they're always very experimental, like in the sense that they would try out risky things, and it's good to have a project like that is covering that space. And obviously, any comments I make about Ethereum, you should keep in mind that we directly
right.
provide an alternative to the
right.
kind of things that they're trying to do.
Okay.